Hello and welcome to this series where I show and explain how a violin is built. Today's video is brought to you by my Patreons. Don't forget to visit my Patreon page if you appreciate my content and would like to support my channel. And by the Galli Strings, an Italian manufacturer of strings, and especially these Overture violin strings, synthetic core, which you can also win. Keep watching the video if you want to participate to the giveaway. In today's video, I'm going to put the neck onto the body, and I'm going to do it in a bit of a different way than usual. In the last years, in the instruments that I made, I had some struggles with this part, and I thought about doing it in another way that I think it could be easier. I have never done it that way in the past, so it is the first time. I have to find out if everything works, so we will see together. But let's take a step back and talk about how usually the neck is placed on the body. Normally, at this stage, you would have the body completed. The mold would be out and the back glute on its place. And then you have to work on this side. You have to open a small gap where the neck is going to fit. What I didn't like with this way of working is that you almost cannot see what you are doing. You place the neck, so that means that the joint from the upper side is not visible because of the fingerboard. You cannot see how the back of the neck fits onto the block because the back is there. And the sides are also almost impossible to control. The other thing that I don't like so much is that you cannot pass through with the file and the chisels. You always hit the back, so you cannot work very nice at the lower part of the gap. As I'm going to do it without the back, you can pass through and you can control from this side also what is happening. I'm planning to glue the neck to the block and then glue the back on its place. Let's start with the neck. It is still square. I have to mark and cut off and shape this side. I will start with marking and I will cut it on the bandsaw. And now, using the chisels, files and planes, I will make a nice flat surface following the lines and the fingerboard. This part of the neck is ready. I'm not going to touch it anymore. Now I will start working on the block, but I have to be very careful as the back is missing, not to ruin or break the ribs. I will mark again the measurements on the ribs and the top, and I will start cutting. Thank you. The neck already stays in place, but it is far from perfect. Not even close, to be honest. But now we can start measuring and controlling everything and removing wood from the places that are going to correct the measurements in the way I want. But let's take them one by one. First, the most important is not to go with the fingerboard, the projection of the fingerboard too much to the left or to the right. And you control that from this surface when going too much towards one side. You have to remove a bit of wood from the appropriate side. If the fingerboard goes too much to the base side of the instrument, then you remove a bit from this side. And the opposite, of course. In this way you control this direction. Then we have this movement, and you have to measure at the end of the fingerboard and at the end of the neck. If the end of the fingerboard is too high, then you have to remove a bit of wood from the upper side. If the neck goes too low, you have to remove a bit of wood from the lower side. And then, of course, there is this height, which you control by opening this gap, so working on the sides of the gap. In that way, it becomes a bit larger and the neck can go a bit deeper. And last but not least, it is the distance from the edge of the top until the end of the fingerboard. And that is also controlled from this surface, but the whole surface. So if it is a bit too long, but the other measurements are correct, the height and the projection of the fingerboard, then you have to remove a little bit from the entire surface of the block. There is a lot to control, and don't concentrate only on one measurement, forgetting the rest. You continuously have to control everything and slowly, slowly, slowly manage to arrive at the perfect situation when you can glue the neck on its place. If you concentrate too much only on one and maybe achieve that measurement, it is possible that something else went off and it's not possible to correct it anymore. I like working in the way that I'm doing now without the bug, because I can see from this side what is happening, and I can also use my files in this way, passing through the gap from both sides, and in this way I have the possibility to work better at the edge. Okay, let's measure a bit and go ahead. Okay, we are on measurement. The height is correct, the height here is correct, the length here is correct. Yes. And the projection towards the bridge is correct. I could glue it on its place, but I am not going to do that because I want to finish the neck a little bit, at least some part. It's now squared and bulky. Also, this side is still square. So I'm going to finish this because now it's much easier to hold it. I don't have the instrument, which is bulky and takes a lot of space. But before we go ahead with the neck, let's talk a bit about our sponsor, which is Galli Strings from Italy. Tommaso Galli founded in 1890 the Galli Musical Strings Company, and he started with the production of natural gut strings. In 1930, they introduced synthetic materials, that gradually replaced the natural gut. When his son Roberto started working in the company, there were innovations in the productive process and advanced machineries. With the third generation, Tommaso started the full automation of the process and computerized winding of the strings. Besides many years of experience, the company also benefits of collaboration with musicians. And if you want to win these violin strings with a synthetic core, subscribe to the channel and leave a comment below and write only the city where you live in, so I can have an idea where you are. In a couple of weeks, I will reply to someone of you who has won the strings. Then you can send me your address and I will send you the set. This part of the neck is finished. This isn't, because I'm going to finish this part as soon as the neck is glued on its place and the back is also on its place. Then I can measure also correctly and finish this part together with the nut which is on the back. Before gluing, as now I'm ready to glue, but before gluing I want to break the corners of these parts. I won't do the whole instrument, only something like that, because it's now easier without the neck on its place. You can also do that before starting the gap. Now that also the corners are done, I can glue the neck on its place with hot glue, as always. Okay, that's it. As it is a very tight fit, I don't need to put a clamp. I will put it down very carefully. That's it for today's video. Thank you very much for watching. Many thanks to the Patreons for supporting my channel. Don't forget to visit my Patreon page. Don't forget to participate to the giveaway for the strings. And I will see you next time again. Bye bye!